Let's talk about the journey. I know there's a bunch of new people here, so let's get into all of it. I'm gonna make it short, concise, and we're gonna get into everything. We're getting into all of it. Hey YouTube fam, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Alyssa Marie, just in case you're new. Today I figured that I would go over my little 2 year, or almost, I guess you could call it 2.5 year, big chop update. A lot has changed in my natural hair care regimen since 2017, so I kind of wanted to go through the difference between what I do now versus what I used to do when my hair was a lot shorter, and kind of just go over everything, how I'm feeling now. I also wanted to give you guys an opportunity to ask any additional questions below in the comments, so get your questions ready. And yeah, we're gonna have some fun today. Before we jump in, please do make sure that you are subscribed to my channel and also hit that notification bell if you never wanna miss a new drop again. Okay, so where do we start? So just in case you're new, let's go ahead and start right in the beginning. So I actually didn't really go natural with the intention of actually going natural. So it was back in 2017, about like early summer, I wanna say it was like around June, where I was just like a little bit curious. Like the curiosity kind of hit me. I had no idea what my natural hair looked like at all. So I was just curious. I was seeing all of the girls doing all these big chops. I was seeing the natural hair movement going on, everybody flourishing, and I was just like a little bit curious. I will say though that I was definitely one of those girls who were like, I will never go natural. Like, y'all look good doing it, but it's not for me. I will never go natural. That wasn't even an option to me at that point. But in June of 2017, I got a little bit curious, and instead of actually going for my relaxer when I was due for it, I made a little decision to see how long I could go without a relaxer. But I just wanted to challenge myself. Like, you know, I was just curious. So I was like, let's see how long we can go without the relaxer. I went a few months and I started to notice that obviously I had two different textures of hair. Like, it was super curly, and I was obsessed with like playing with my roots and feeling like the little curliness, and then feeling the straight. Like, it was just so weird having the two different textures. So I started to experiment with my hair a little bit more, and what I actually started to do was to wash and goes with my relaxed ends. It was crazy. But I put tons and tons of like curling custards and everything to try and get my relaxed ends to curl up as much as they could. It ended up with like a little bit of a wavy vibe, but I don't know, it kind of worked. I did braid outs as well, and once I was doing the braid outs, I noticed that I actually really liked how I looked with curly hair. Now at this time, still didn't decide to go natural, still was like, I'm still gonna get a relaxer soon. Like, there was no commitment whatsoever. This was literally just me being curious and having a little bit of fun. It wasn't until about August, September that I was kind of like, you know, maybe I should go natural. Like, this would be kind of cool. Like, I genuinely did not like my hair straight anymore, and I really thought, like, I don't know, it just gave me new life. I had straight hair for so long, and that's what I'd always wanted, what I'd strive for. But there were two things that stood out to me. Once, I hated getting my relaxers because my scalp would burn. I would like say prayers before the appointment because of how painful it was. So there was that. And then two, I really started to genuinely enjoy the look. And after seeing all those girls and the natural hair movement, they were just rocking it, right? So I was like, all right, you know what? I think I might actually go natural. But still, at this point, it wasn't really a commitment. It was still kind of a thing in my head where it's like, let's see how long I can do this for. So my initial decision was to just transition for a year. Let's see if Liz can go a full year without a relaxer and see what happens. It was never like a commitment, like, I'm going natural, that's it. You know, I was just like, let's see what happens, whatever. I lasted up until December 2017 when I decided to get my big chop. So there were kind of two factors that really played into me just saying, you know what, forget it, screw it, let's do it, let's just big chop it off. Well, actually, I would say three factors. So one, my hairdresser, who was a Diva Curl hairstylist, she was located in the Cayman Islands with me, which is where I was living at the time, and she actually told me that she was leaving the island. And this was about, I want to say, this was like sometime in November. She's like, yeah, I'm leaving the island. And I was freaking out because she was really helping me with transitioning my hair. She cut my hair a little bit shorter in a bob because I found that when my hair was a little bit shorter, my relaxed ends would curl up a little bit more, and I just like, I don't know, it just helped a lot. So she was giving me lots of curly girl advice. She was really cheering me on. She was my person. So I would say, actually, if you're looking at me right now, you're transitioning and you're struggling, make sure you find a hairstylist that you trust, somebody you can talk to, a professional that you can really go to for all your kind of hair advice. So anyway, she was my person and she was leaving the island. So I kind of felt under pressure, like, oh my God, like, who's gonna help me through this? Like, what's gonna happen? So the second thing that happened was that I realized that I was putting my hair back in a bun all the time. And I personally hate my hair in buns. I like my hair out. That's just my preference. Y'all see me all the time. Like, I love to rock my hair out. That's just me. Don't get me wrong, I love a good bun, like, every once in a while, but my preference really is to rock my hair out. And I had my hair up in a bun every single day because I was so sick of the two different textures. I could not handle it. It was so frustrating. If anybody who's transitioning, you'll understand 100% what I'm saying. And I kind of was just like, you know, my hair's in a bun every day. I look bald anyway. Like, why not just chop my hair off? So that was the second thing. So my hairstylist was leaving. I kind of wanted to get in before she left. And I was frustrated with my hair. And then the third thing was that I went through a breakup in December. And I did make the appointment and everything before the breakup happened. But that was just like extra fuel because the breakup happened like literally the night before my big chop. And it was like huge. And I was just like so fueled and ready to go. Like, I did not go into my big chop feeling, I mean, like, don't get me wrong, I was like nervous, but I didn't go in feeling like I was gonna regret it. I was like nervous, but like so sure of my decision, like to the point where even my mom, who's my best friend, was telling me don't do it, and I was like, no, I have to do it, like, this is for me. Fast forward to today, my mom has also gone natural by big chop, but anyways, that's a whole nother story. So yeah, that is basically how my big chop started. It has been an incredible journey ever since then. Honestly, I've never felt so free. I've never felt so beautiful and so confident in myself. So I have consistently been able to say throughout my entire journey that even though it has been a little bit hard, a little bit overwhelming sometimes, it is still the number one best decision I've ever made in my entire life. And I don't know, I've just experienced so much freeness and so much self-love and so much love from other people from like way across the globe. Like, it's been absolutely crazy to be able to just connect with so many other people in the hair community. Like, the natural hair community is lit, y'all. It's lit. So when I first started out, like right before I did my big chop, I made sure to go to the hair store and I started out with a couple of things. So I started out with a leave-in conditioner. I made sure to get a gel. I got a spray bottle and then I got a brush, and I think that's all I really started out with. Oh, and I got a tail comb because I knew my hair would be short and that's kind of like all you can do with it. So those are the few things that I started out with. And comparing my natural hair regimen to what it was before versus what it is now is like completely night and day different. So if you have a TWA and you're watching this, tune in, listen up. First things first, when I did have my little TWA, I was wetting my hair every single day. Like, whenever I would shower, I was wetting my hair. I was like literally sticking my head under the shower and that was it. I feel like for short hair, you don't really have to worry about like over wetting it because one, it like dries immediately, it's short. And two, because my hair was so short, like whenever I would sleep on it, you'd wake up and like the sides would be like completely matted down. Like, it had to be refreshed every single day. But because it was short, it was like super easy to refresh. When I started out as well, my natural hair was definitely not this tight. My curls were a lot more loose. They were very wavy and just kind of lazy curls in a way. So I actually used to have to finger coil my hair a lot. But again, because it was short, it really wasn't that difficult. It didn't really take that long. So that was something that I was willing to do every day. So I actually didn't use a spray bottle as much as I thought I would. Literally, it was just wetting my hair fully underneath the sink, the faucet, whatever I had at the time. And that was really it. And then I would just go in with my leave-in conditioner and my gel. And that was basically it. So if you guys are interested in checking out some of my TWA styling videos, I still have them here up on my channel. So I will link them here as well as in the description box below so you guys can check those out as well. So on the other hand, nowadays, now that my hair is a lot longer, the curls are a lot tighter, I definitely don't wet my hair every single day. That sounds like a headache to me now. Like, with a TWA, you say wet your hair and it's like, cool, easy, no problem. When you have longer hair and it's like, wet your hair, is like, girl, like, do I have to go through all of that? Because it's a lot. So basically, with my current natural hair care regimen, I put in a lot of effort on wash days. so that I could go like 3 to 4 days without actually having to worry about my hair at all. My spray bottle is also my best friend. I use one that has like a very nice mist, so it can just mist over all the hair. The one thing that I have done ever since the very beginning of my natural hair journey and still up until now is do my weekly deep treatments. I preach this to you guys all the time, but this is like so important in order to keep your natural hair happy, healthy, and just like popping, okay? For most people who tell me that they struggle with their curls, I say, okay, do you have a consistent natural hair regimen? And then they'll be like, no. And I'm like, well, sis, this is why your curls are struggling. So definitely having a consistent regimen with consistent deep treatments every single week, like that is so important. I can't even stress that enough. One thing I have also noticed was that I've always been like kind of a fan of more natural makeup, more chill makeup. But when I had my big chop, I don't know if it's because I went through the breakup or if it was because the short hair, my face was showing more, like my makeup was bold and on point. Like I definitely wore a little bit more makeup when I had a short cut, but it was cute, honey. It was cute. I wore bold lips, I wore lashes, big earrings. Like I had so much fun with it. And honestly, probably sometime in my 30s, I will probably go back to chopping my hair off. It was that much fun. I really enjoyed the big chop and that whole journey. I just like, it was just so much fun. But yeah, I definitely noticed it now. Like this is my go-to look, something glowy, a little bit gloss on the lips, and that's pretty much it. I definitely rock a much more natural look with my hair like this. Oh, another thing that has changed within my regimen for short versus longer hair is that I definitely trim my hair a lot more often now. When your curly hair is longer, there is so many more things you have to deal with, like single strand knots and split ends and all that, especially because I have colored hair now as well. So I make sure to do my trims every 4 to 6 months. More times it's towards the 4 month end and less towards the 6 month end. Although now we're in quarantine, we're stuck. So I went ahead, had to curl dust my own hair at home. I'll tag that here and below if you guys wanna check that out as well. But yeah, when my hair was short, like I never ever really thought about cutting it. I guess because I did when I chopped it, like I chopped it for the reason of growing it. So like trimming it really wasn't in my head. And also I was just learning, like I had no idea the importance of trims. I know that now. But back then I was kind of just like, just going along like, all right, let's just let my hair grow. And honestly, it wasn't so bad because your hair is so short, it's really difficult to actually damage it unless you're just completely butchering your hair. So you can totally get away with stuff like that when your hair is a lot shorter. What else I also noticed, when my hair was shorter, I used to experiment with so many more hairstyles versus now, like I just like the little simple out and then up and then out again. Like when my hair was short, I used to do like side part here. I used to do little mini puffs at the top. I used to do like, I just used to try all these different kind of things. I used to do my edges a lot, I guess because they would show more. And it's weird because you would think like with shorter hair, you feel like you can't really do anything. But honestly, with like long hair, it's just so much work to do styles that it's kind of just like, I'll just leave it out today. It'll be fine, you know? That's definitely another thing that has changed as well. But yeah, I love every part of my natural hair journey and I'm so glad I started with a big chop. I'm such a huge advocate for that just because of everything that I've learned and like grown through my whole big chop journey. It's just been amazing. So if it's something that you're considering and you feel like, you know what, like you'll rock it, you'll do it, like go and do it and just make sure that you're doing it for you. You don't wanna do it for Tom, you don't wanna do it for John, like you gotta do it for yourself. And if it's something you feel like you need to change, and you decide like, you know what, no matter how it's gonna come out, you're gonna rock it, do it. Like 100% go, it's gonna be amazing, I promise you. And then hair grows, like look at my hair and like under 2.5 years later, this is my hair. This is like, this is crazy. It really grows and all you have to do is just have patience with yourself and honestly just have fun with it. So yeah guys, that is basically my 2.5 month big chop update. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any additional questions for me, go ahead and comment them below. I really look forward to seeing all of your comments and questions. And before you leave, you can also check out 2 more videos as well. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Bye.